When I was in high school, I went on an exchange program to Italy, and while we were in Florence, I think it was, we went out and did a wine tasting thing, and it was April Fool's, and we came back and left our friend David, who was a sophomore at the time, behind, and told our teacher that he had gotten arrested for underage drinking.
Today in Contemporary Art Lecture, we were looking at Robert Mapplethorpe photos, and some of them are highly indecent, caused a lot of censorship issues at the time, including like gay, S&M, bondage, nudity. And the next place I walked through was the first floor of Newcomb Hall, where they got those lovely black and white photos of things that happened to Tulane once upon a time, and I would love to switch those out with some Mapplethorpe posters.
So last spring break, I was hooking up with my boyfriend, and then like looked him in the eye and was like, I don't think I can do this anymore. And I like rolled off of him, and then he was like all freaked out and like was like, what's wrong? And I was like, I think I'm a lesbian. And he like got really freaked out and like bullied me for like 10 seconds until I said April Fool's.
Alright, so in sixth grade, on April Fool's Day for sure, I stole a girl in my class with chapstick because she was always just going around her face with it. And I chopped off the chapstick part, and then I took like a big one of those big fat glue sticks, and I like dipped it inside and dug out all the glue, and I rounded it off on top so it looked like chapstick, and I put the cap back on, and I put it back in her purse, and then I was sitting across from her in class later that day. She just glue all over her face, and she freaked out. It was funny.
I was a good little girl up until eighth grade. My parents were really freaked out because I was dating a black boy, and I was not like having sex or anything, but whatever, it still freaked them out. Anyway, on April Fool's Day, my mom was out of town and I called her and I said, Mom, I have something to tell you. And she's a very serious woman. She said, what? What, are you okay? I said, Mom, I'm pregnant. And it was dead silent. Oh my God, then she lost it. I could hear her screaming, I could hear my dad screaming in the background, and I let it go on for like 3 minutes, and then I said April Fool's Day. But they really didn't think it was funny, it was really scary.
So when I was in like sixth grade, my dad is like he doesn't sleep well at all. He has like sleep apnea and always has a really hard time falling asleep and staying asleep. And when I was in sixth grade or something, I thought it would be a really good idea to put not just one alarm clock under my parents' bed, but two. So there was one set for like 2:30 in the morning, then one set for 4:30 in the morning. Like the first one went off and my dad apparently got like really, really mad. And then like finally, and I put it like deep under their bed, like in like a bag of, you know, clothing or something. So he just like woke up and had to like, you know, come around and find it. And then like went back to bed really, really angry and like couldn't really even sleep. And he'd just fallen asleep again when the other one went off. And I could like hear him, I've seen my dad mad maybe twice, and I could hear him like roaring as he's like stomped down the hall and like practically tore my door off its hinges. And that was when I knew that I'd made a mistake. It was really scary.
A good prank is tiny cups of water lining the entire hallway of a dorm, so when you open your door you can't but help but knock them over.
So on April Fool's, put saran wrap across the toilet seat really, really tight so it's still clear. And then when people go to the bathroom, whatever they do will pop up back at them. It's really funny. And that's how I prank my friends on April Fool's Day.